Oye, clava las ventanas que por ahí viene el huracán del Caribe, muchacho. Esa mulata es un dolor. Agárrate la peluca. Cuidadito. No existe un meteorólogo en el mundo que te pueda descifrar. Y si del 1 al 5 fuera el centro de huracanes, 6 te diera. Fuertes vientos se desatan con ráfagas desenfrenadas, haciendo estragos en mi corazón, sintiéndome atrapado en el ojo del ciclón. Hoy debo ir a la ferretería, entablar muy bien mi pecho y poderme proteger. Mulata, cuando caminas todo el mundo se despeina, se me rompe la ventana y hasta se me huele el techo. Todo el mundo te llama el huracán del Caribe. Y todo el mundo te llama el huracán del Caribe. Oye, cuidado que viene. Esa mulata es un dolor.
Okay, so I'm here with Jesus today at Hains Pipe Shop. Jesus, tell me a little bit how you, tell me about the pipe shop itself. How, what kind of history is this place? And
well, it was established in 1890 by the Hains family, and it's the 7th oldest in the United States. While I was working in Lancaster, the manager of the shop, that the Muse Tobacco Shop, he lived here in York, and he told me about the shop being for sale. I was working already for the oldest in the United States, and I thought it was interesting to see if I could get my hands on the 7th oldest because of the history. Plus, you know, the history itself of the town, Red Lion, York, when it comes to tobacco. So I came, I met with Steve, the previous owner, and I was able to get it, put my hands in it, and make it a better place, start rolling cigars. It's like my, you know, workshop.
Okay.
And from here is what I, you know, make a lot of friends since I started now.
So how long have you been in the cigar business?
Since 1994. That is like 18 years.
So how did you start out?
I started out like an apprentice.
Where?
In the Cohiba factory.
In the Cohiba factory,
yeah.
In Cuba?
In Cuba. My mother helped me to get the job, and I started learning how to make cigars. And after 6 months, you know, I made it to the, I passed the test and they sent me there. And that's how I learned. Rolling a lot of Cohibas daily.
So you met your wife in the Cohiba factory?
We met at the factory. She was also a student when I got there. And, you know, little by little we created a friendship and all that. And she gave me a few instructions of how to roll cigars because she was before me. During the training, I got 3 months after, and she was already there. So the guy who showed me how to roll cigars, he came to me, gave me a bunch of leaf, and kind of told me what to do, but I didn't get it at the moment. And she was the one who stand up and came to me and, you know, told me what to do to start. After that, we became friends. What happened is she's from Guantanamo, and I'm from Havana, but I knew Guantanamo because my mother, my grandma, lived there, and every year I would go for vacation. So we start talking about, you know, Guantanamo, and became friends and all that. Till one day it just happened.
And you guys been married for how long now?
Same amount of time, 18 years.
18 years. Okay, so tell me you grew up in Cuba.
I did.
Under the communists.
Under the communists, yeah.
Kind of difficult hearing some of your story.
Kind of difficult. I was lucky enough to not get in trouble with the Castros. Because there is a high risk, you know, to get in trouble. Everything is wrong there.
Well, I know you always say.
And for 29 years, I was with them there.
Wow.
Surviving.
Howdy, howdy. So you came around here.
What's
around
everybody?
How you doing?
Are the boxes in?
Boxes in, my friend.
My wife ordered one for me, so you've been calling her. Oh.
She did? All right.
You need it now?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, I never did, obviously. So yeah. The guy who came in the boat from Miami, since immigration go after you, they know where you're located in the country. They were looking for me after 4 days. But I was sleeping in my friend boat by then, waiting for a propel to be fixed. He came with one of the propel broken. So I was sleeping in that boat. That one night, the anchor got loose, and the boat was going away. In the middle of the night, I wake up, and I see myself in the middle of the ocean, like going away. I jump, I start swimming toward the house where it was. My friends were sleeping inside. I didn't stay in the house because immigration break in your house and find you there, and you're back. They send you back. So then I was swimming. I woke them up because I didn't know how to start that thing to bring it back to land. And the guy said to me, "Well, if you're wet already, go back and get it. You know, pull the rope and bring it over here." I was afraid of the sharks. Is that typical?
And this is his dream. I like to see him blow it up as possible, big as possible, you know, because he has a great product. You know, everybody who smoked one of these, do what I do. Come back. Come back and try to buy bundles, you know. So I'm very happy for him.
When I came in, I met the brother here, Derek and Adrian, and they welcomed me in as part of being the family, and I've been here ever since. Hmm.
Very cool. So what was it about, like, you were looking for specifically in a cigar shop? Because I was looking for something specific when I came. Mm-hmm. So exactly what were you kind of hoping to find?
Just a warm environment conducive to enjoying my pleasure, which is smoking cigars with pleasant company and good cigars. And music.
Yes, sir. Start the interview.
So tell me a little bit about yourself, man.
Well, my name is Adrian. Been enjoying Jay Castenon for approximately 4 years now, as of September. I came in here on my birthday, my 40th birthday.
And you were... The pipe story.
I came in originally wanting to smoke a pipe on my 40th birthday. And while waiting to smoke a pipe, Jesus was rolling, and I said, "Well, explain to me what you're doing." He explained to me. I said, "Well, I'll try that." And I started smoking a cigar. He told me how to do it, and I fell asleep. And I woke up in the chair with the cigar still in my hand. And I went home, I told my wife, "I don't ask any questions because I can't explain it, but I now smoke cigars." 4 years later, I'm still enjoying Jay Castenon.
So you've been like in and out of here for 4 years, man. I mean, like I was telling Derek, like you two were the first two we met when we came in here. Kind of made me feel at home, made me feel like it was a kind of a cigar community. What is it about this place, man, as you just dig so much?
It's like anything else. You know, people take on the personality of the leader. And Jesus is a very family-oriented gentleman. So the atmosphere takes on that family same kind of family atmosphere, and you become a part of it. You come here, that's what we are. We're family.
The guys just welcomed me. It felt like a family atmosphere. I think I'm going to be the one who coined the phrase as the clubhouse. I mean, it's how it felt, you know, a bunch of guys getting together, just enjoying a cigar and company, in one another's company.
Cool.
Jesus has always been very welcoming of everyone coming into the shop, very friendly. And, I mean, he's the one who's really created that atmosphere of a nice, friendly place to come and enjoy a good cigar.
Mm. So what's your favorite smoke?
I vary, you know. Initially, I went with the Minuteman. They made such a fuss about the Chicho. I smoked a couple of the Chichos. I was young, wasn't really ready for it, so I went back down to the Mariba, which was really good.
Mm-hmm.
And now they've, the big seller now is the Corona. And on the heels of that is the Fusion. And so...
You've been coming in here for a while. I've been seeing you kind of come and go for a little while. Tell me what it is about this place you like so much. I mean.
This cigar shop is, to me, like a for real old school cigar shop. In where I used to live in North Carolina, there's an old tobacconist shop where you can hang out and people spend the day hanging out, smoking pipes, smoking cigars. Mm. And this place has that exact same kind of feel to it.
Oye, cuidadito que esa mulata es un ciclón, muchacho.
Y todo el mundo te llama el huracán del Caribe.
Esa mulata es un dolor cuando pasa.
El huracán del Caribe.
Mira quién viene por ahí y mírala.
El huracán del Caribe.
Ahí viene esa mulata.
So, where are you from, Tony?
I'm from Cuba, Havana.
Havana, Cuba.
Havana, Cuba.
How long have you been in the States?
I've been in the United States for 32 years.
32 years.
I came in 1998 with the Mariette leaf.
Okay. So what? How long have you been hooked up with these guys?
Almost a year, no?
A year,
no? A year.
Yeah. So I see you all the time when I come in. How you like hanging out here with these guys?
Wonderful. Yeah. I like the smell of the cigar and everything.
Yeah.
Con gris. Carne con papa y ensalada aguacate con zanahoria.
He made a salad of
con
mojito,
con mojito, no con
pan. Then he made this. It has some vinegar. ¿Qué más tiene?
Ajo, cebolla,
garlic, ají, onion, pepper,
aceite, vinagre,
oil, vinegar. That you
okay.
Can put on your salad.
Se llama mojito.
And it's called mojito, like the drink.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So if you have some yucas or stuff like that, you can do some stuff.
Come el pan.
Then he made some meat with the potatoes.
Mm.
Oh,
right. Wow, okay.
Salsa. And rice and beans. Rice and beans.
Very cool.
Yeah, pretty good. That's Kiki, the chef.
Yes.
Muy bien.
Hey, Daniete. Do you hear how that sound? Lean back and smoke it.
Uh-huh. Lean back and smoke.
How about doing that all day? With all, you know, everything taken care of.
Yeah, then you don't have to talk about killing each other. Oh, that's crazy. All that crazy shit. Yeah.